Due to the following USA special, Murder, She Wrote, The Law, and Harry McGraw and Diamonds will not be seen tonight. Catch Murder tomorrow at 8 and Harry and Diamonds next week at their regular time.
All the lyrics rhythms, arrangements just perfect for 50s American rockabilly, courtesy of arranger and saxophonist Teddy, Mr. Bear McRae, and his orchestra with Hi-Fi Baby. And we've got a rather fine Hi-Fi Baby in store for you this evening in the form of our carefully arranged playlist for the next 2 hours, just perfect for late night radio here Thursday night on BBC Radio Scotland. And you've probably deciphered already, it's not Natasha this evening. Yes, myself, Ravi Sagu, sitting in for Natasha. I'm with you right through until 12 midnight. And a big, massive thank you going out to Anna Massey for tonight's Travelling Folk. As per, I was listening en route into the studios in my car. She had a fantastic live session from Scottish supergroup Session A9, who were playing new music from their brand new album, The Magic Roundabout, a cracking cartoon. Well, not a cartoon, but cracking animation back in the day as well, all things children's TV. You can of course listen to Travelling Folk and Anna Massey on BBC Sounds at your pleasure and indeed leisure. Coming up this hour, I'll be playing music from the likes of The Average White Band. We'll throw in some fantastic Valtos, Rich Kids as well. In the late great feature, I'll play a track in honour of Pete Rodriguez, and in Talk of the Town, I'll play a track from Kenny Anderson himself, yes, King Creosote. And talking about Talk of the Town, Camera Obscura have been at Talk of the Town, first album in 10 years or so. It releases next month. Look to the east, look to the west. This is Big Love.
It was a big love, she said. That's why it took 10 years to get her out of your head. We watched you swirl, she peek up the room.
All that lovely DNA of Camera Obscura, lush instrumentation, melodies, and those fine vocals from Tracy Ann Campbell. A brand new album, first in 10 years or so. Look to the east, look to the west. That is Big Love. It releases on the 3rd of May on Merge Records, and yes, it's available to pre-order. They've got a number of gigs all over the UK and US. Scottish stop-offs, Saturday the 11th of May at the Barlands in Glasgow, and they're playing the Glasgow weekend, SW3 weekend of the 2nd of August. I'm sure they've got one or two other gigs littered in between as well. Catch them live then. You can get in touch with us on the show this evening. It's always open house for dialogue on your text, any messages on Instagram, a bit like our playlist. So yeah, you can perhaps comment on our music, and indeed just let me know what's been happening at your end. 80295 on text, and you can get us on social media as well. The Natasha Raskin Sharp show, radio show on Facebook. And if you want to hit me up on the gram, Instagram, it's simply at Ravi Sagu Gram, and I'm sure we'll get some chatter and chitties through the night. Switching it back to, well, Scotland, keeping in Scotland, but in a kind of way of America, this band, they went to America and they were embraced by black music audiences, which was quite a feat back in the day. And I was very lucky enough, alongside producer Nick, to interview Alan Gorry for Summer Soul last summer for BBC Radio Scotland. And he was telling me, and Nick, that this is definitely their final farewell tour coming up in the summer. I'll give you those dates after a classic. This is The Average White Band with Work To Do.
Sometimes
if you're going to do a cover, do it well. Average white band, and work to do covering the Isley Brothers. And like I was saying, the farewell tour kicks off next month. This is definitely the final farewell tour, as Alan Gorry was saying last summer here on BBC Radio Scotland. Dates for your diary: the 7th of May, they're in Glasgow, they're playing the Royal Concert Hall. 8th of May, they're up at the Music Hall in Aberdeen. The 10th of May, it's the Perth Theatre and Concert Hall. And the 11th of May, it's the Usher Hall in Edinburgh. Producer Nick and I are already sort of trying to sync diaries to see where we can go and catch the Average White Band for one final time. And while staying in the realm of that kind of powerful black music from America, this next record, in fact these next two records, got a bit of a story to it. So when I mentioned a carefully arranged playlist, yes, we do think about it, or certainly producer Nick does. I just come and, you know, play the records and maybe talk a little bit. But yes, a giant of post-war Mississippi blues who defined Chicago's swaggering Delta-rooted sound. I mean, talk about emotive vocals, powerful vocals, and that piercing slide guitar skill, Muddy Waters. But this record, it was actually written by Willie Dixon, and it was the subject of a 1985 court case over plagiarism against a song by Led Zeppelin. It was actually heard by Willie Dixon's daughter, and that led to the whole court case, and they settled out of court. But we'll play both, and we'll see what you make of it. First up, it's Muddy Waters, You Need Love.
You got yawning and I got funny. Baby, you look so sweet and cunning. Baby, way down inside, woman, you need love. Woman, you need love. You got to have some love. I'm gonna give you some love. I know you need love. Just got to have love. Got to have some love. You make me feel so good. You make me feel alright. You make me feel so good. Oh, you make me feel alright. You make me feel so good. You make me feel alright. She's so nice, so nice. So nice, so nice. So nice, so nice. So nice, so nice. You are fretting and I am petting. Lot of good things, you ain't getting. Baby, way down inside. Woman, you need love. I know you need love. You just gotta have some love.
You need cooling, baby.
First up, we played you Muddy Waters with You Need Love, which led us very nicely into A Whole Lot of Love from Led Zeppelin, who adapted aspects for that 1969 hit of theirs. And in 1985, yes, that court case over plagiarism by Willie Dixon, who wrote You Need Me Love, was settled out of court. If you were the judge or perhaps even the jury, let me know if you'd go in the favour of Willie Dixon. 80295. And some good memories of Top of the Pops there as well. You're listening to BBC Radio Scotland. Myself, Ravi Sagu, sitting in for Natasha Raskin-Sharp right through until 12 midnight tonight. And time now for us to honour a late great of the musical world. And this evening, Pete Rodriguez is our late great, who was an American pianist and bandleader, born in the Bronx, New York City, to Puerto Rican parents. His specialisms, it was all about Latin dance music, the genre of boogaloo, and he passed away aged 89 only last month, leaving a lasting musical legacy that spanned over five decades or so. And this perhaps one of his most famous, if not his most famous record to date. It was featured in so many varieties of pop culture. I'm thinking video games, Grand Theft Auto. I'm thinking the cinema, namely the Odeon. They had it as a massive ident for a while. Lots of samples and many cover versions. And a current supermarket is using it as well. Honouring our great late Pete Rodriguez. I like it like that.
I like it like that.
What a celebration of musical legacy in tonight's late great Pete Rodriguez with I Like It Like That. Love that boogaloo. Passed away sadly last month and actually takes me back to my university days. I did a documentary with some of my uni colleagues in salsa, merengue, boogaloo, and I'm sure we used that very record for some backing tracks on that film, which I've got somewhere on VHS. I'm going to have to pull out that VHS somewhere from my archive, and I'm actually going to have to find a video recorder to see it. But yeah, tonight's late great Pete Rodriguez with I Like It Like That. Bringing the music back to Scotland, I'm really a big fan of this next crew. This next record, they've just got this perfect electronic dance underscore with sort of traditional Scottish roots and beats. They come from the Isle of Skye, which I've recently driven through. I was in the Isle of Lewis in February, out filming, doing some work for BBC Alapa, and managed to drive through the Isle of Skye. My first time ever, absolutely gorgeous. And it's Martin McDonald and Daniel Docherty, of course. They make up Valtos, and this is Charlie's on the Run. We'll be right back. Fabulous Valtos with Charlie's on the Run. They're gigging in the month of May, Friday the 3rd of May, Queen's Hall in Edinburgh, and the 30th of May, the Loreburn Hall in Dumfries. And they're also around for festival season, namely Hebkilt and the Bute Festival in July.
Join me, Nicola Meehan, for The Culture Scene, a collection of highlights from BBC Radio Scotland's afternoon show. You're talking to Michelle McManus.
It could take me right up until the first night of the tour to decide what I'm going to play.
How are you, Lulu?
I do feel like I'm 15 again because I get a high from doing that on stage.
The winner of this year's Sir Billy Connolly Spirit of Glasgow Award was announced as Susie McCabe.
The best bit was a garou from Jeannie.
Face your audience.
And a Hollywood superstar, Russell Crowe. He told me about his Scottish roots.
People that I'm related to, that's just blown my mind, you know?
The Culture Scene. Listen on BBC Sounds.
And culturally, I'm about to switch up the music. We're heading to Bollywood. I grew up with Bollywood. I've starred in Bollywood, I will tell you all. But this is a brand new soundtrack to a brand new film. And the track, it's the title track. And if you know anything about Bollywood, they're very good at sort of masala genres. Masala means a spice blend. And that means, yeah, they blend the genres. So this is, believe it or not, a sci-fi rom-com. And it's a reworking of the Canadian R&B's artist Raghav. 2004 version. This is really hypnotic. Bollywood just knows how to rework a song. And yeah, you'll hear some of the original lyrics from Raghav as well. But the title track to the film, Teri Baaton Mein Aisa Ujhliya Jiya. Bollywood songs and musical soundtracks, hypnotic and gets you grooving. That's the title track to the brand new film starring Shahid Kapoor and Kirti Sanon, Teri Baaton Mein Aisa Ujhliya Jiya. I'll give you a rough translation. Being in your words, being in your company, you've mesmerised me in my heart and love. And yeah, if you've not checked out Bollywood, do it. The soundtracks are phenomenal. The choreography is sublime in that very video. And talking about all things Bollywood, I actually starred in a Bollywood film. When I say starred, you could maybe see my thigh and my kilt at the tail end of last year. And I actually made a programme about it, or making a programme about it for BBC Radio 4. It's called Bonnie Bollywood, and it's celebrating 25 years or so of Bollywood and Indian cinema using Scotland Scotland as a backdrop, and yeah, it kind of tells my tale of a missed chance 25 years ago of starring in one of the biggest films, but I managed to get myself into it, and yeah, just speaking to the actors and the production crew and just kind of, yeah, recharting this story of, you know, Bollywood in India coming to Scotland using it as a filming location. It's called Bonnie Bollywood and it broadcasts sometime in June on BBC Radio 4, so do look out for it on BBC Sounds. And you know what that music means now? Yes, it's time for Talk of the Town. Songs about places, as Natasha does each and every week. And well, the town that we're off to this evening, the Firth of Clyde, for me personally, it reminds me of childhood trips in the 90s with my mum, my dad, my siblings, my cousins, my neighbours, anyone who'd come along with its Victorian promenade. We'd be fed ice creams from the parlours and shops. If we were lucky, we'd get a poke of chips as well on the way home. And yeah, lots of Viking heritage as well. This town famed for a battle in 1263 when the Vikings attempted to land from a fleet of longboats, but they were repulsed by the army of Alexander III. Yeah, you can tell I've been doing some research. I don't remember that from my history school days at all. And of course, we're celebrating the town of Largs, as they do annually with the Largs Viking Festival. This is high pace, high energy. Get your deck tears out. It's King Creosote and we're off to Largs. So who cares if nothing comes out of this morning but an ocean of sea and an ocean of sun and a deck chair all but broken when Sunday upon. Each of us is as backwards coming forwards. Sounds with me while you're keeping stum. My mind's still as blank as that postcard. what a celebration in song. All things sand, deck chairs, ice creams, postcards, caravan parks, coastal sunshine, perhaps even your sunglasses. I had them on earlier and then the rains came in when I was driving in to BBC Radio Scotland this evening. Tonight's talk of the town, courtesy of King Creosote and Largs. And talking of King Creosote, Kenny has a string of live dates kicking off this month. Oh, so many to mention on air. Check them out online. But he is doing the festival season as well, namely the Tartan Heart Festival in Bewley come July. And I did double check, no dates listed in Largs yet. That would have just been oh so perfect. You're listening to BBC Radio Scotland. Myself, Ravi Sagu, sitting in for Natasha Raskin-Sharp this evening. And a man who has a number of dates, including coming to Scotland, is the Mod Father himself, Paul Weller. He dropped a brand new album at the very start of this month called 66. And this, taken from that very album, is Rise Up Singing. As ever, great delivery and great vocals from Paul Weller from his brand new album 66, Rise Up Singing. 15th of April, he's playing the Alabama Theatre in Dunfermline. 13th of July, Edinburgh Castle. And he's heading to Caird Hall on the 27th of October and the 28th and 29th. It's a double dunt at the Barrowlands in Glasgow. Now, we're going to play a little something from Rich Kids back in the 1970s after being in a teeny pop band called Slick. Our very own Midgeur, he embraced punk. He joined up with former Sex Pistols bassist Glenn Matlock and formed the power pop band of Rich Kids. And Midgeur, he is actually also gigging as well. He's playing the Rewind Festival, which takes place in July at Scone Palace in Perth this very summer as well. So let's rewind it back. This is Rich Kids and Ghost of Princesses and Towers.
Hey.
What riffs to end that record? Rich Kids and Ghosts of Princes and Towers. I've been really looking forward to playing this record all night. Winners of BBC Introducing Scottish Act of the Year, Bottle Rockets, as part of the prize. They've got a spot at Transmit this summer. This is Backburn.
I can see in your eyes you never felt that way before, and you just want to go home. You're sweet enough in surprise. Kiss me twice, then out the door, and I just want to go home. Well, it all.
Phenomenal band, phenomenal talent. That's why they picked up the BBC Introducing Scottish Act of the Year, Bottle Rockets with a Backburn.
Radio with Ravi Sagu on BBC Radio Scotland.
another Hindi lyrical track to kick us off this hour from Nazia Hussain with Disco Diwani, which translates to being in a state of craze. And that very record, that Hindi disco pop era of the 80s, yeah, my aunts, my uncles used to listen to that when I was a wee kid. And that record actually took her to overnight fame because she was one of the first artists from that kind of Indian, Pakistani, Asian sort of genre of wider music to take Hindi lyrics into that Asian pop disco arena for the very first time. And believe it or not, you might have heard this in Mexico because for some reason it's a massive, massive hit over in Mexico. But that's what happens with music. It trends in territories beyond, you know, explanation of perhaps language barriers and whatnot. That's one thing I love about music. Nazia Hussain with Disco Diwani kicking us off for the second hour. Myself, Ravi Sagu, sitting in for Natasha Raskin Sharp tonight. And coming up this summer, we'll play music from Fee Sacred Souls, one of my favourite soul bands of the current movement. Gautier, Wilson Pickett, plus something from the Beatles. Always play a little something from the Beatles, as does Natasha. So we'll bless a track from Angela McCluskey. But staying in that, or perhaps moving into that sort of soul, electric, pop, R&B vibe, Ray picked up a whole host of Brit Awards, and rightly so. She's got some voice, quite a talent, great vogue as well, and obviously lots of hints of Amy Winehouse as well. I think she picked up best album, best song, songwriter of the year, new artist, R&B act. Yeah, she picked it up all. And this, her sort of new gen take on the old 21st century blues. This is Ray with The Thrill Is Gone.
Card games and heart games, I said let's play, I should know better. My boy ain't my boy, but I call him that cause it feels better. Court case last Monday, but he bust trials, so I feel better. Painkillers and codeine, I got stomach cramps under my sweater. Dark words from his dark mind, now there's dark stains under my eyes. I'm scared when I look at him and I don't know why, I'm surprised. Silk sheets and I'm crying in them and I'm staying here when I should go. I'm scared if I leave now, I'll never come back, so I sip slow. Say something nice to me, say something nice to me. I know that I agree, you get so mad if I disagree. So he invited me to sit here silently. He can't stand the sight of me, he used to get excited. In the same bed as you, something just doesn't feel right. When you fall asleep, I leave the room as you're closing your eyes. I shut the door behind me quickly, so I get in my car. But then the second I leave you, I wish I was late. Say something nice to me, say something nice to me, say something nice to me, please.
Go. My 21st Century Blues is a debut studio album from Ray. She's got it going on and that soul electric pop R&B vibe. And yeah, I'm definitely getting vibes from Amy Winehouse inspiration as well. And the record was, of course, The Thrill Is Gone. And she's playing Coachella this weekend, so definitely she's arriving on the global tip as well. And festival season, Reading and Leeds, nothing for Scotland just yet. Fingers crossed she will bless us with a few gigs up here. Her gorgeous, almost chilled out and almost slightly subdued, but in a classical and just beautiful way from Angela there, who sadly passed away only a few weeks ago for our feature this evening, Something by the Beatles. And of course, if you've come across any unusual suggestions of covers of the Beatles, why don't you get in touch with us on the usual ways, and I'm sure Natasha will spin them over the next couple of weeks. And well, staying on that kind of Beatles connection, with a bit of Wings this time, obviously Paul McCartney heading it up, this is Another Day.
Every day she takes a morning bath, she wets her hair, wraps a towel around her as she's heading for the bedroom chair. It's just another day, skipping into stockings, stepping into shoes, in the pocket of her raincoat. It's just another day at the office where the papers grow. She takes a break, drinks another coffee, and she finds it hard to stay awake. It's just another day. It's just another day.
Another Day, Paul McCartney and Wings. And well, it will be another day in just less than half an hour or so before we switch over to our friends at BBC Radio 5 Live. But plenty of music coming your way before we do so. We text in from Dee Dee in Kelvin Bridge, who's dropped a message in on 80295. Really interesting mix of tunes tonight, Ravi. Cheers. And that's coming in from Dee Dee. Dee Dee, I'm glad you're liking this kind of carefully curated but open house playlist that we've got for you this evening. And switching up the flavours even more, Dee Dee, this one going out to you. This next lot, they were part of Britain's ska revival, and then they got into the sort of pop and soul elements of what Blighty does as well. They're touring this summer, 5th of July. They're playing at Edinburgh Castle, a plethora of other dates as well. This is Madness, and let's enter that house of fun. Firstly, we were in the House of Fun with Madness, which led us into Hide Your High with from Deaf School, rather. And for those of us with perhaps a more attentive ears, will have heard more than a coincidence perhaps there, with the same piano break coming from Clive Langer, who was in Deaf School, and he also produced Madness. So that's perhaps where that break and link comes from. This next record comes via Belgium and Australia and kind of came out of nowhere. He dropped this banger and then he kind of became someone we used to know.
Said you felt so happy you could die. I told myself that you were right for me, but felt so lonely in your company. But that was love and it's an ache I still remember.
Was the biggest selling hit of the year in 2012. Somebody that I used to know from Gautier. He was the man behind the productions and indeed the vocals alongside Kimbra from New Zealand. A fine, fine record. And then, yeah, just kind of vanished, didn't it? But then that's what happens. Maybe you make your money from a big hit record and then you sort of relax a little bit. Bringing the music back to Scotland, Glasgow-based duo Raintown, they've announced the release of their third studio album called Acoustic Heart. It's out on Friday, the 26th of April on the Country Acoustic Tip. And this is Redress from that very album.
Corner there all alone. I've been watching you all night long. You're looking good to me. We're part
Husband and wife combination that is Rain Town with Red Dress from their brand new album, releasing in a few weeks' time, Acoustic Heart. They're also taking that album out on the road. 17th of May, they're performing at Oranmore in Glasgow, and 29th of June, they are live in Nairn Community Art Centre. Lots more music across BBC Radio Scotland from Friday night and indeed into the weekend. Grant Stott is back with his vinyl collection from 6pm tomorrow evening. All things classic and new releases. And on this week's show, English singer-songwriter Ed Harcourt shares his special vinyl collection from his own record collection. And of course, the countdown of the top 10 albums of this week from 1977. So join Grant at 6 o'clock tomorrow. BBC introducing Phoebe, bringing you the best unsigned, undiscovered and under the radar music from Scotland, and that's kicking off from 8 o'clock, leading into Ashley's Story back for Friday Night Tunes, including our feature Hollywood Swingers, and Saturday night Billy Sloan back from 10 o'clock, all things pop rock and so much more. This week he's in conversation with Tim Booth of James. I Saw James many years ago, great band, and his live and dangerous track this week comes from Creedence Clearwater Revival's live gig playing at the Royal Albert Hall, recorded in 2022. So it's all happening across Friday and Saturday here on BBC Radio Scotland. Of course, you can listen to this show and all of our other shows on BBC Sounds as well at your very own, well, pleasure and time, and, you know, whatever suits you. We're fast approaching almost the end of the show, but we've got 12 minutes or so. But bringing the music back to Scotland, massive fan, played Jerry Burns a few weeks ago. In fact, when I was covering for Natasha last time during the month of January, in fact, we played this on Burns Night. Do you get it? Jerry Burns. What a voice. Last night from Glasgow Records have re-released the Jerry Burns 1992 self-titled LP. That released actually at the very start of the year. There's four bonus tracks as well. And there's a plethora of options. CD Deluxe, red vinyls, you know, white vinyls. So if you're a collector, trust me, you will be absolutely in your element. And this was the opener from that very album, Pale Red.
Thank you.
great voice, so well written, produced as well. Just those sort of arty, soft pop vibes of the 90s. Jerry Burns and Pale Red. On to our next track. We're going to pay homage a wee bit to Rab Noakes now. He was a founding member of Steeler's Wheel, a revered solo artist in his own right as well, released more than 20 albums and took centre stage across many festivals, including Celtic Connections. I was lucky enough to be in his company many times, and one thing that just evokes memories when I think of Rab Noakes, always had fantastic shirts, great belts and fantastic shirts. What a character. This is Rab Noakes with Clear Day.
Wake up in the morning with the sunshine
to my window and it's making me rise.
Wake up in the morning with the sunshine
to my window and it's filling my eyes.
Wake up in the morning with the sunshine
to my window and it looks alright.
It looks alright.
Couldn't agree more with the lyrics of that very record. Everything is going to be all right. Clear Day from Rab Noakes. Massive thank you to you for listening in tonight, and it's been lovely sitting in for Natasha once again here on BBC Radio Scotland. Natasha is back next week, so she'll be taking over the reins, and thank you again from me, Ravi Sagu. Playing us out tonight, we've got a classic from Wilson Pickett, 99 and one half.